Well, hello and welcome. I'm Peggy. Thank you for letting us be a part of your day. And I have a chance to learn a lot today. And I think anybody who lives in this part of the United States, we all have the same situations. And we see the growth coming all around us. And it's all not all bad. It's good. But we have a lot of things that we have to meet and deal with. And I have somebody right here who's going to tell us what to do. Bob Mihalik is here. He is a spokesperson for Greenville County. But Bob, if you don't write in Greenville County, you could be in Asheville, you could be anywhere around in the Southeast, and we all have the same situations.
Yeah, most of us face the same issues. Yeah. And we're very lucky right now to have the issue of growth be an important issue, not only in Greenville County, but throughout the upstate and into Asheville and the surrounding areas, because we live in such a wonderful place. The word has gotten out.
But I've heard a lot of people say, Bob, oh, I wish people would stop coming.
Well, that's we want to hear that, because right now at Greenville County, we have our comprehensive plan, which is something by law we have to do every 10 years. The state of South Carolina says a community needs to do a comprehensive plan, and the number one thing that gets addressed in that plan is growth. And the number one important thing about the plan is getting community involvement. And so we've been having community meetings throughout the summer. We have a website designed. We did some phone surveys to find out what the community wants, how they want to grow, if they want to grow, and hear what the community solutions are to go along with the solutions that our professionals come up with.
What are some of the things that we see happening that we have to deal with, whether we want to or not?
Yeah, well, one of the issues that was dealt with by the state legislature that impacts us on the local level, as you mentioned, throughout the entire upstate, was the passing of the gas tax by the state legislatures 2 years ago. And now that gas tax has kicked in, and that's helping to deal with the main issue that we always get is we don't have enough roads to support the people, and the roads that we do have are deteriorated. And that is a correct assessment. I mean, when, you know, this infrastructure was built for about, you know, in Greenville County, about 375,000 people. Well, now we're close to 500,000 folks that live in Greenville County alone, not to mention throughout the entire upstate. And so our infrastructure needed to catch up, and part of growth was improving our roads, keeping our infrastructure strong to keep the economy going. So that's something that was addressed on the state level. On the local level, we have to determine, how are we going to grow? Do we want to keep sprawling out into our communities? In Greenville County, a lot of people say, well, you know, you have your downtown Greenville, then out in Simpsonville, and up to Traveler's Rest. We've been growing with all these subdivisions. Do we keep growing that way? Do we grow with infill? And by that, that term means, do we start building sort of on top of one another? And instead of building large subdivisions, do we build townhouses and you know, slightly, you know, 2 to 3 story buildings to have housing? So there are a lot of issues that come with growth. Growth is a wonderful, wonderful thing.
Well, I think we could use a little of both.
And that's usually the response
that we get. A lot of people like to live downtown.
Right.
And some people want to live out, as you say, in the Traveler's Rest area or out away from the city. Right. But we're blessed because we have the choice.
Yep. And at the end of the day, the free market determines what people want to do and where they want to live. You know, some people say, oh, I can't believe you'd want to live out there in Five Forks with all that traffic and all those subdivisions. But a lot of people live there because they like it and they think a 25-minute ride to work isn't that bad. Others who lived out there for years, it used to be a 10-minute drive to work, are like, whoa, this is a little bit too much growth. So you have sort of two sets of people, you know, those who have been here and watched it grow around them, and the growth sort of negatively impacts them, and they're looking for a solution. But a lot of the people who are moving here because exactly what you just said. The quality of life is wonderful, and we actually do have a decent infrastructure, and we have, you know, great climate to, you know, to live in, both economically and the physical climate. And so we're trying to balance off the old and the new as we grow.
And we have so much. We have a good recreation. We have nice parks.
We do.
We have a good theater, if you want theater.
Yeah.
We have a first-rate symphony orchestra, which many people in other parts of the country don't have what we have.
Yeah. And you know what's amazing is one of the big economic development tools that we have in our community is the Swamp Rabbit Trail. People love the Swamp Rabbit Trail. We started it 10 years ago. It was an 8-mile trail. Now that trail is almost 20 miles long, and every meeting we go to, people say, can you make it go longer? Can you branch off into this area? Can you come into our part of town? The Swamp Rabbit Trail, the Prisma Swamp Rabbit Trail, has really been a blessing to our community. Not only does it, for those of us who have lived here all these years, we love having the recreation opportunities to take your family out, to use it as transportation to get from one place to another, if it's so be it. But a lot of people, when they decide where they're going to move, and a lot of companies that decide, do I want to have my headquarters in the area, look for recreational opportunities. And when they see the Swamp Rabbit Trail and how popular it is, I mean, we have more than 500,000 people use the trail a year.
And about
30% of them, from our latest survey, 30% of them come from out of town. They're tourists that come, and part of their little mini vacation, you know, they'll get a bed and breakfast up in Traveler's Rest, and they'll get on the trail, and they'll bike or run or whatever they do, and they'll go into downtown Greenville, and they'll get lunch and dinner and ride the trail back, and they consider that a wonderful day off, and they're coming to our community to enjoy our assets like that and help our community grow. So the trail's been very popular. Conestee Park, which is just south of I-85, we sort of envisioned that park 5, 6, 7 years ago as being the central park of Greenville and Greenville County. Now, when we said that, people were like, oh, yeah, well, you know, there's a lot of green space down there. Well, just in the last 5 years or so, all the development happens, and all of a sudden you go, ooh, it's a good thing we preserve this wonderful chunk of green grass and baseball fields and trails right in the middle of our community. So the Recreation Department of Greenville County has been very forward-thinking. We have a lot of quality green space, and folks have been asking for trails at every park. They want somewhere to walk, which I think is fabulous. It's part of a healthy community, is a great community. So, you know, even a lot of our baseball fields that are strictly set up for baseball, we've created walking paths around there so that the moms and dads and grandmas and grandpas and the rest of the family, you know, in between games or even when there's not a game there, can just use the trail to go for a nice walk, because that's what the community has asked for.
What is this Upstate Alliance? What is it?
The Upstate Alliance is an economic development group and a marketing group that takes the upstate as a whole, 10 counties, and markets it to the world. So, and the Greenville County is certainly a part of Upstate Alliance, along with our own economic development group, the
GADC.
I don't
think we need that marketed.
well, the marketing for that is for businesses, which is great. But that's, you know, we've joked that everybody's done such a great job, both our Visitors Bureau, you know, all our GADC of bringing, you know, businesses that want to be here, that some people go, okay, we've got enough.
Yeah.
Well, you can't have enough jobs because
the
economy is roaring right now and things are wonderful. But it's not always that way. I mean, think back to about 10 years ago when we call it the Great Recession hit.
Yeah.
You know, we were actively recruiting a lot of businesses. We didn't have very many housing starts. Our codes department, you know, wasn't all that busy because there weren't a whole lot of new things to go and inspect. Now it's off the hook. It is just nonstop. There's new stuff coming up left and right. And while we recruit a lot, it is the upstate as a whole that's able to present itself on the national level to bring in top flight employers. And that trickles down and translates to every part of our community, including Greenville County, obviously.
Well, somebody was saying the other day that many people retired from the north, maybe they used to go to Florida. Now they come to the Carolinas.
A smart move, right?
Because we have the ocean, we have the mountains, we have a nice climate.
Yeah.
You don't have to shovel snow in the winter.
it's a wonderful place, and that is a growing population in the upstate of South Carolina, certainly in Greenville County, is our senior population. A lot of them are Clemson graduates who go out in the world and like to come back
they
to the place
and
be around an area that they know is so wonderful, but it is a big economic driver, having folks retire here and the senior population has grown so much that we've needed to address that even in our recreation department. And at the end of the month, we're opening up the Berea Community Center.
What is that?
Well, the Berea Community Center is in Berea. It's at the corner. It's on Huntsbridge Road, right at the corner. Used to be an old Blockbuster video, but we repurposed it. And, you know, remember Blockbuster videos? Those are a thing of the past. So we repurposed this facility, and it's going to be run by Senior Action, which is a state-run group that provides activities for senior citizens. It's everything from just getting together for lunch to having parties to having dances to doing sporting events to playing cards. And so that community center is going to open to the public right in the heart of Berea. And again, when the county makes a decision on how to use their resources, We don't go out and say, we're going to build a community center that's going to serve seniors. We do a lot of research first, and the community will tell us what they need. And as little as 5 years ago, and especially 10 years ago, you could see the growing senior population in our community. And we made the decision we have to keep our senior programming at a premium and find a good central spot for everyone to enjoy some senior programming. So that Berea Community Center is going to open at the end of July and serve a lot of residents in the Berea area, but also a lot of new residents, as you mentioned. It's a wonderful mix of folks who, you know, have been graduates of Berea High School 30, 40 years ago and want to make sure their community keeps thriving, to the new folks who have moved here and have all these wonderful opportunities, but are sort of looking for a group to hang out with, a group of peers, and they could find that at the Berea Community Center starting July 31st.
Well, we have recreation. Mm-hmm. You want to talk about some of the things that are available?
Well, you know, there's a lot of opportunities for everybody to get involved. Mostly, like we said, people, when we've done our surveys, most people said, we just want somewhere we could walk in peace and not have to worry about cars or you know, safety. So a lot of our parks are based in having walking trails. Throughout Greenville County, Greenville County Rec has 55 different parks. 55 different parks. And a great thing to do is you can go to greenvillecounty.org or you can go to greenvillerec.com. And if you go onto the website, we call it a park finder. You can click on a button and a map pops up and it'll show you, you know, all the parks that we have all throughout the county. Because a lot of people, if you live here and you only drive that way, you don't realize if you just went to the right, there's a beautiful park sitting back there that can serve your needs. So a couple of years ago, we created this Park Finder webpage that just shows you where all our parks are. There's one in your community, I promise, wherever you live in Greenville County, there is one. And they're always multi-purpose. Almost every one of them has a walking trail. You have green space. You have playgrounds for the kids to play on. You have ball fields. This time of year, the water parks are very, very popular. Kids love it, but you know, the grandmas and moms and grandpas and dads like it too because it entertains the kids for an afternoon, and they have some fun splashing around in the water. So we have three water parks throughout the county. Those are wonderful options. We have a fantastic aquatic complex. It's called the Greenville County Aquatic Complex, and it's located inside Westside Park, not far from the Berea area, on the west side of the city of Greenville. It is a world-class aquatic facility, and they do everything from senior programming through the morning to having Olympic-quality swimmers working out there throughout the afternoon. And it is a facility that has this unique air vac system that takes the chlorine out of the air. If you've ever been to a pool, it always smells like chlorine. Yeah, it makes it difficult, but not at the Greenville County Aquatic Complex. You wouldn't know you were at a pool. The system is so wonderful. So you can spend hour upon hour there, and they have the big Olympic-sized swimming pool there. They have a smaller pool, which they use. They call it the therapy pool, where you can do your exercises of that nature. So it's the complete deal, and I think it's a hidden gem. You know, it's used so often for these major swimming competitions that sometimes the community forgets that we have this wonderful aquatic complex that's available to citizens pretty much at any time to go in there and swim some laps or join a program and do some therapy sessions and do some exercising. So it's a great facility, and the location's great. Just on the west side of Greenville, easy to access. So that aquatic complex has really been a blessing to our community and serves a lot of people.
Well, Bob, I can well understand how you are a spokesperson for Greenville County, because I love your enthusiasm.
I love working there with you.
We're going to go to a quick break, and we'll be right back. So we have more information for you.